My name is Albert Willemsen, appointed by ICOMIA as the environmental consultant, working since 1988 with all kinds of environmental issues and also related to antifoulings and biocidal products. One of the founders of the environmental committee within ICOMIA, still working, representing the industry in Brussels on behalf of the marine industry, but also coating industry and other parts of the marine industry. Related to all kinds of European legislations, international regulations, also representing ICOMIA in other parts of the world, all related to environment and coatings. The BPR is one of the main four regulations in Europe. It's related to registration, authorization and restrictions. The other one is CLP, which is related to classification, labeling and packaging. And the third one is the BPR, the Biocidal Product Regulation. And the fourth one is what we call the Rotterdam Convention, which is related to transport, and in this case not very important for us. Biocidal Product Regulation is a European law. This European law requires that all biocidal products or biocides should be risk assessed and registered for the European market. This ensures that antifoulings can be safe used by the user and is safe for the environment. All the products placed on the market in Europe must be in compliance with the BPR. That means all the antifoulings, products whose, let's say, containing any biocides. Existing and new biocides and biocidal products will need to be re-registered before placing them on the European market. Any products who is not, let's say, in compliance with the BPR and not assessed by the BPR is allowed to be sold up to June 2018. The do-it-yourselfer is allowed to use it after June 2018 up to December. After the December, when it's not in compliance and not assessed by the BPR, it's not allowed to use it anymore. We have to realize, let's say, that the current products available on the market in Europe can be changed. The difficulties on this moment is that the assessments within the BPR are not equal, and some member states are demanding a more strict assessment and they want to have a different product for inland waters or what we call marine waters. At the same time, they want to have a more or less a harmonized approach so that they can avoid that the consumer can buy any products from other countries in Europe. And this is a really a difficult issue. It will be available for in the future, but the consumer and the do-it-yourselfer and even the professional has to realize that the products in the future can be different from the current available products. One of the goals of the BPR is protecting the environment. Not using antifoulings is not always protecting the environment. It can be also a big threat to the environment. The second environmental threat worldwide is loss of biodiversity caused by invasive species, and invasive species are caused by fouling. Controlling and managing fouling is meaning, in fact, controlling and managing the impact of a loss of biodiversity. Looking at, let's say, the publicity around invasive species from the Netherlands to the UK, 19 different and new invasive species were imported from commercial ships and yachting to the environment of UK. Biocidal products will be more and more difficult to assess and to be allowed to place on the market. If you want to have more information on the BPR or more information about antifoulings, first of all, search to the website of the different paint manufacturers. Everybody has a special part related to antifoulings, related to the SDS sheets, as we call them, the safety data sheets, how to apply, what kind of conditions you have to apply, etc., etc. Everything is available in relation to the product. If you want to have more information in general, you can search to the ICOMIA website, and on the ICOMIA website you can find the National Marine Industry Associations in relation to your country. You can find on the website of the National Marine Industry Association more and more information about, let's say, anti-foulings, the developments in your own country, and the developments around assessments.